In this next example, we need to find the area of hexagon EFGHJK. First, plot each of those points. Now, when connecting these points, make sure that you connect in order of the name of the polygon. In this case, the name of the polygon was EFGHJK. And then back to E. And so to find the area of this hexagon, we'll need to split it up into simpler shapes, into shapes that we know how to find the area of. Now, we've talked about finding the area of triangles. So if I split from E to G, then this top piece is a triangle. And I can do the same trick with this triangle down below. And the leftover shape, this kind of shape made by E, G, H, K, I know it's a trapezoid. The reason I know that is EG and HK are both on grid lines. And so that means they're parallel, and so that means that we have a trapezoid. So to find the area of the combined region, we'll first find the area of this blue triangle. And remember, triangles are found with area equals 1/2 base times height. And the base, in this case, would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units long. And the height, remember, the height is the perpendicular distance to the base. The height is 2. So the area in this case would be 1/2 times 6 times 2, which is 6. So the top region is 6 square units. The trapezoid, this red shape, remember trapezoids are found with the area formula 1/2 times the sum of the bases, B1 plus B2, parenthesis, times the height of the trapezoid. Now we already have one of the bases. We know that this length is 6. This length is 1 longer. It's 7. And the height of the trapezoid is the distance between the two bases. So this distance, if we can count boxes, is 1, 2, 3, 4 units tall. So the area of this trapezoid is 1/2 times the quantity 6 plus 7 times 4. And if you stick that into a calculator, you get that that is 26 units. And finally, the triangle down below. Again, area of triangle is 1/2 base times height. And if we consider 7 as the base, and remember base and height are perpendicular, so the height would be 2, the area would be 1/2 times 7 times 2, which of course is just, which is just 7. And so the combined area is 6 plus 26 plus 7, which equals 39 square units. Now, it's worth mentioning that this is not the only way to split up the original hexagon. It is possible to split it up into different ways. Here's one possibility. You could have split it up into this blue triangle, right here, this purple triangle, green triangle, red triangle, and yellow triangle, and this kind of gray rectangle. And if you chose to do that, well, we know that this blue triangle would be 1/2 times 4 times 2 should be 4. This purple triangle will be 1 half times 2 times 2, which is 2. This green triangle is 1 half times 2 times 4. Sorry, 1 half times 1 times 4, which is 2. This sort of reddish triangle would be 1 half times 4 times 2, which is 4. This yellow triangle will be 1 half times 3 times 2, which is 3. And the rectangle that's left over would be length times which is, let's see, 6 times 4, which is 24. And we have 4 plus 2 is 6, plus 2 is 8, plus 4 is 12, plus 3 is 15, plus 24 is 39. So we have 39 square units. So the point in showing you this slide is there's no one right way to split up a polygon. The key is to make sure that you fill in the polygon in order of the letters given to you, E, F, G, H, J, K in this case, and then split it up into simpler shapes.